class 10. Today we are going to revise the topic of determiners. Already we have done it. Okay, so now we are going to revise determiners. What are determiners, first of all? Right? For example, there is little milk in the jar. This is my pen. So here the main noun, for example, there is little milk in the jar. So now here in these cases, these are the nouns, okay? And mostly determiners, they are used before the nouns, okay? Right, milk, sorry, right? So now it means that it is clarifying more to whom this pen belongs, that it is my pen. Okay, next one, little milk, how much milk? That there is little milk in the jug. So it means that they are adding some more meaning. They are clarifying. Okay, these words, they are clarifying or fixes the meaning of noun. These are called as determiners, which fixes the meaning of the noun. What are these called as? These are called as determiners. So what are the different categories of determiners? Article determiners. Quantitative, possessive, demonstrative determiners. Okay, so this we are going to do today, right? And as well as there is one more category, that is numeral determiners. So first of all, coming up to articles. So articles, what does they? Okay, a, an, and the. A, an, they are called as indefinite article, and the is called as definite article. Now why? Because here a or an, they doesn't refer to a particular thing. Okay, there is a pen in my bag. Okay, I have a pen. It means which pen? This I'm not showing. I'm not giving any indication. Okay, an umbrella is a useful thing. Okay, I'm talking about any umbrella. I'm not referring to a particular thing. But if I talk to particular thing, for example, the umbrella in my bag is a new one. So here I'm saying that which umbrella? The only umbrella which is in my bag. So here I'm referring to a particular umbrella. Okay, the boy is sitting on the first desk. Okay, there are many boys in the class, but here I'm referring to a particular boy who is sitting in on the last desk or on the first seat. So when we are referring to a particular thing, then what is there? The is used. What is used? The is used. So if we will see the individual role of A and N. So these are where used? A and N. Now, what is the difference? An is used before vowel sounds. Which are the vowels? A, E, I, O, U. And A is used with the, what then? Which sound? Consonant sounds. It is used with consonant sounds. It means that all the other alphabets, apart from or other than A, E, I, O, U, these are called as consonants. Properly last point. Okay. So, these are called as consonant sounds. Now, moreover, what this A represents? Where A is used? First of all, they both are used with singular countable nouns. When we are talking about single thing. Okay. Singular countable. There is an umbrella. There is an orange. There is a pen. Whatever. Okay, I have a pen with singular countable nouns, A and N is used. Okay, the difference is it is used with vowels, it is used with consonants. Okay, then afterward, they always give a sense of one. Okay, they always give a sense of one. Okay, for example, it costs 25 rupees a dozen. Okay, or it is always giving the sense of per. For example, per. Okay, per liter, the milk is 45 rupees a liter. It is also used for quantities, right? Okay, so a is used with you can say singular countable nouns, and these are the various uses of a. So in case of exclamatory sentences, can you give an example of exclamatory sentence? For example, what a beautiful scene, what a wonderful painting. Okay, so now it means that when we are using exclamatory sentences, so there also what we are doing, we are using a. Okay, so per I have told you it is also used with quantities, right? So there a or an is used. Now coming up to the definite article. So where it is used? First of all, the is used whenever we are talking about a particular thing. Okay, right? For a particular thing. Okay, for example, the chalk in my hand is of red color, suppose. Okay, the name of historical buildings you are talking about. Okay, the Red Fort, the Taj. When we are talking about a class, a complete class. Okay, for example, the camel is the ship of the desert. So here I'm talking about all camels, right? That the camels are, all the camels are ship of the desert. Okay, tell him, maintain gap, please. So next afterwards, for example, the dog is a faithful animal. Again, I'm representing all class of dogs. Okay, so then also the is used. Next, it is also used when we are representing all the constituents of a class. For example, the rich. Okay, it is a collective noun used for all the rich people, the hungry, the poor. It is again representing a class. Okay, so there the is also used, right? Next, afterwards, the is also used with the names of newspapers. For example, the Tribune, the Hindustan Times, the whatever it is. Okay, it is also used with the name of the rivers, the Gangas, the Brahmaputra, the name of the mountain ranges, the Himalayas, okay, the Kanchenjunga. Okay, and it is also used when we talk about this. I have told you the rich and the poor. Okay, so then the is also used, yes, with the name of the bodies. Okay, the heavenly bodies, for example, the earth, the moon, which are one of a kind. Okay, there also the is used. The earth, the moon, the sun, which are one of a kind. For mountain valleys, we all have done, yes, with the name of oceans also. The Indian Ocean, the Pacific Ocean, right? The is also used, okay? With the name of the islands also. For example, the Andaman and the Nicobars, okay? So, with all these, stand up. So with all these, what is there? The is used, right? Okay. So understood this, right? The is used. So do you have any doubt in a, an, and the, where the is used? Okay. So the is used with when we are referring to a particular thing. This is the main thing, right? Okay. The is used there. Fine. The earth, the universe, which are one of a kind. Then what we use the. Okay, what we use the. Okay, which are one of a kind, we use the. Right? So these are the different uses of the. Next, afterwards, the next category of the determiners that we have are possessive determiners. Now, possessive determiners. Possessive, which show possession. This is my pen. This is your bag. This is your book. Okay. This is his house. Okay. This is her new dress. Okay. So, what are these? These are different examples which are showing possession. Okay. But mine, for example, this house is mine. that is not possessive determiner, that is possessive adjective. So don't get confused. This, for example, my, your, his, her, these are the examples of possessive determiners, okay, which show possession. Simple things we are speaking, okay, right? Okay, the simple words which are representing the possession, these are the examples of possessive determiners. Students are still entering the class, I don't know why. Okay, next, afterwards, we are having numeral determiners. Numeral, as the name indicates, what it indicates, that they will tell us about the number. Okay, so there are two types here. One are the definite ones and the indefinite ones. So to indefinite ones, we will come on later on. First of all, we will talk about the definite ones. So what are the definite determiners? First, second, third, fourth, and so on. And next, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. But there must be difference in these two. What are these called? Can anybody tell? First one? No. Which is the category of determiners? Can anybody tell? These are the ordinals and these are cardinals. Ordinals and cardinals. Because they tell us order. First, second, third, fourth. This is the reason why they are called as ordinals and these are called as cardinals. Okay, these are definite determiners. Why they are definite determiners? Because they tell us about definite quantity. Okay, right? There are two pens in my bag. Okay, there are two students left in the class. Okay, so as these are telling, you can say the particular or the definite number. This is the reason why they are called as definite. Okay, the fourth student in the class is the winner of the competition. Okay, so in this manner, they tell us about a particular, okay, definite thing. This is the reason why they are called as definite ones. But here now coming up to indefinite. Indefinite means they never give us an idea of a definite quantity. Okay, they don't give us an idea. For example, sum. Much we will take in quantitative ones. Here we are talking about numbers. Sum. Sum gives the sense of less. Okay. Few, a few. Okay, and the few. So what is the difference? This we are coming to it. Sum. Okay, few, a few, okay, then many, several, these are the examples of these, okay, then all also. So now coming up to sum, for example, there are some students, okay, sum is used here in number also, sum can also be used in quantity also, okay, for example, there is some milk in the jug, it can be used for both, right? Few, a few, and the few. Can anybody tell what is the difference between few, a few, and the few? Okay. Few means more than negligible ones. Okay. A few means little more than few. Okay, it is not negligible, but we can consider. Okay, for example, a few students have nominated their names for the competition. Okay, means very few, not many. Okay, few means negligible. Okay, and the few means the very less in number, but those all. The few students in the class present have all submitted their names for the competition. It means that all the students who are present in the class, they all have submitted their names for the competition. Okay, right? The few cakes which were left after the party were all consumed. Okay, it means that whatever is left, everything. Okay, so this is the difference between few, a few, and the few. Okay, next afterwards we are having many more in number, right? Okay, so many toys have been destroyed, okay, due to earthquake. Many houses have been destroyed due to earthquake, okay? Many boys have entered the room, okay? So several, against giving a sense of many, but it does, many means enormous in number. But what is the difference between several and many? Several means several, including many, okay? Several, if you are talking about if we are talking about numbers, it means many of those, right? Okay, several students have consented to go for, or many, several students are ready to go to the trip, right? Several assignments are left on my part, means I have not done many. Several are left, okay? Several, several people, they have suffered from this kind of infection, okay? So it means if we are talking about a number of those many, okay? Next, all, what we are talking about, all the students have joined the class, okay? All is well, that is, that ends well. Okay, if we are talking about all, means whatever we are talking about, including all. Okay, so this is the example, okay? Next is distributive determiners. Distributive determiners, for example, which your distribution, okay, for example, each, every, either, neither, okay? Either is used in positive way when we are talking about two. For example, either of the students, okay, can go out. Neither means no one. Neither of the students can go out, okay? As it is the period going on. Each and every. Each means when we are talking about a single one. Okay, each student is given an apple. Okay, each student is distributed his or her, you can say, performa, right? But every means when you're talking about a class, it means all in the class. Okay, every student in the class has to follow the rules and regulations. It means I'm talking about all the students, and of all means I'm talking about everyone. This is the difference between each and every. Okay, it means when we are talking about class, every means all the constituents of that. Okay, each means when I'm talking about class, I'm talking about individual constituent of that part, right? So this is the difference between each and every. Okay, right? Then afterwards we are having quantitative determiners. Quantitative determiners, like we are having for those. You will have your grammar book next time, okay? Yes, quantitative determiners means here we are talking about quantity. For example, some can also be used here. Okay, much, enough, much work is left on my part. Much has to be done in this case. Means quantity, we are not counting it. It is used with uncountable. Okay, when we are talking about quantity, enough. Enough, okay, that's enough, okay, right? Or this much milk is enough for the preparation of this dish. Means this is, we are talking about quantity, we are not talking about particular number, right? Then in the same case, earlier we are having little and the little. There is little milk in the jug means negligible amount. Okay? A little, there is a little milk in the jug means which can be used for making tea, means something is there. The little means all the little milk left in the jug is used for making tea. Whatever it is, whatever was there, the complete thing was used. For example, he had spent the little money he had. Means jitni uske paas thi, he has spent all the money. Okay? The little means that. that if we are talking about something, it means that all the complete thing. Okay, so afterwards we are having, yes, the last one we are having, demonstrative determinants. Demonstrate, naturally what they do, they demonstrate the things. For example, this is a board, that is a dice, okay, this and that, near things, this and that thing is used for further things. Okay, so this is just an overview of the determiners. As both online and offline class is going on, so I thought that I would share the exercise, but if I would share the exercise, you people won't be able to see. Okay, and for that you will have your grammar books with you by tomorrow, okay, in the next class, whenever it is. Now first of all, I'm going to ask you few examples. Now you people will give me the answers for those. Yes, first of all, dash day she visits India Gate. Dash day, that day. Okay, dash people will come in the zoo. Many people will come in the zoo. Okay, dash friends were involved in that crime. All friends, many friends, some of to hai nahi, nahi them. Okay, next. Dash one will come definitely. Huh? Everyone will come definitely. Someone will come definitely. Next. Dash no and fewer care. Dash no and fewer care. Dash no and fewer care. No one know and fewer care. Everyone know and fewer care. Many know, fewer care. Okay, all know, fewer care. Right. Dash people would like it. Many people, some people, or the people, both are correct. Next, you should ask the bank for dash money. Some money, right. Dash grapes are sweet and juicy. Dash grapes are sweet and juicy. These grapes are sweet and juicy. Okay, all grapes. The book is dash thing operating the mind. Is the thing. The book is the thing operating the mind. Two dash boys are taking part in violent activities. Two dash boys are taking part in violent activities. Too many. Good. So, shopkeepers are charging high prices for dash apples. Apples, plural. For these apples. For some apples, there is dash milk in dash glass. There is some milk in the jug. There is a little milk in the jug. Okay, everything is right. There is much milk in the jug. That is also right. Have you dashed money in the bank? One thing I forget to tell you at that time, some and any. Any is used for negative one. There. ठीक है ना, हैव फॉर एग्जाम्पल हेयर इट इज, हैव यू सम मनी इन द बैंक और हैव यू एनी मनी इन द बैंक, व्हेन वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग अ नेगेटिव रिस्पांस, एनी कैन बी यूज्ड. डू यू हैव एनी पेन फॉर एग्जाम्पल लाइक वी आस्क. ओके, नाउ डैश पीपल से दैट ही इज मैड. सम पीपल से दैट ही इज मैड. ओके, नेक्स्ट, ही वॉज डैश फ्रेंड. He was his friend. Okay, he was my friend. Okay, the teacher suggested to follow dash dash constructions. Okay, suggested to follow his. Okay, right. His is also right. Next, dash great freedom fighters made India free. Dash The freedom fighters or many freedom fighters made India free. Next, a director of the company had built dash temple. The temple is right. Next, mind dash business, the teacher ordered. Mind your own business. Right. Don't say dash thing when dash thing is clear. Don't say anything when everything is clear. Right. So, there was hardly dash milk in the bowl. There is hardly any milk in the bowl. There is a little is also right. Okay. Next. There was the Ramayana is dash ideal. An ideal, I is there, which is a wall. You may call me dash time. Anytime. Honesty is dash best. The best. Yes, I forget that example. I skip that example. Whenever superlative degrees are there. Superlative, the best, for example. Then what we are using? The is used with superlative degree. For example, most. He is the most beautiful. Okay? Superlative degrees are there, then also the is used. Next, I have dash work to do. Some work, much work, both are correct. He has dash wealth than his brother. He has dash wealth. Much more, enough. Enough wealth than her brother. Okay, it will be corrected. Next, dash country is India and we love her. My country or our country is India and we love her. Don't become dash enigma to society. Don't become dash enigma to society. And is there na? Next. Dash is my pen. Okay. These are dash mistakes in your... Sorry, there are dash mistakes in... Many mistakes in your concepts, right? So one more exercise. Let us go through. He ate dash breads I had. All. How dash stories does this book contain? How many stories? Whether dash man came from Mumbai? Whether dash man came from Mumbai? That man. Games are compulsory for dash students. For all students. He was dash only man who could bear such loss. The, where we are talking about the means the particular man. Okay, is there dash message for me? Any. They have eaten dash apples. All apples, many apples, right. There is dash water in the glass. Some water. Next, Meena had dash milk. Some. Dash Gita is famous for philosophy of life. The Gita, religious book. Okay, with the name of religious books also. I have dash money to spend on luxury. Some money. Okay. I can't lend you dash money. Any money. Negative sense. I can't lend you any money. Next is Rohan is playing with dash father. With his father. Right. How dash students read in dash school? How many students read in this school? We can get as dash help as we like. We can get as much. Many is used for countables and much is used for uncountables. Okay, so that's all for today for the topic of determiners, class 10. And next Monday you are going to have your test Monday, and it will be intimated to you, right? So that's all for today.